First, now the sacking of the Kenya Ferry Services Managing Director Musa Hassan. Musa has now exposed the rot at the state parastatal, with cases of mismanagement and graft now being cited. And the axing has elicited mixed feelings among users of the ferry services, who now want a total overhaul of the system and pitfalls fixed. KTN's Francis Ontomo with an update.
Well, the age-long crisis here at the Kenya Ferry Services appears to have reached its peak now with the sacking of Musa Hassan Musa, the managing director here. About 300,000 people use the Kenya Ferry Services here, and about 5,000 vehicles, making a huge statistics of what has been here at the Kenya Ferry Services. Well, a lot has been proposed, or rather said, about why the Kenya Ferry Services MD has been sent packing. Another one of them, of course, has been the characteristic congestion that has been here. A lot of delays has characterized affairs here, and crossing from one point to the other has been a hassle and a huge headache for many here. Business people, tourism stakeholders have been raising serious concerns about what has been affairs here and what has really hampered progress in these sectors. Well, many are saying that it is a blessing in disguise that the managing director has been sacked, and perhaps now they are looking forward for a better leadership and something that may actually boost affairs here and give the Kenya Ferry Services a facelift to be able to make affairs move smoothly.
Nimefurahi sana kwa MD kwenda shauri ya hiyo shida iliyokuwa hapo nyuma, na vile tuna hope kama MD atakuja mwingine management itakuwa sawa. Nikiongelea kwanza kuhusu hizi banda, unakuta banda la wanaume watu wanafinyana sana, kida inakuwa idadi ya wanaume ni wengi, na pale mahali wako katika kambo katika zizi, yani ambapo tukifunguliwa katika ile banda la wanaume watu nabanwa sana. Sasa tunataka MD anayekuja aangalie huko katika banda la wanaume pia wapanue kidogo.
Kenya Ferry imegeuka sana, imekuwa kila siku ni msukumano. Ferry yaweza kaa baharini hapa karibu lizadi zima, watu wataka kuvuka. Pengine maradiso kama na via ferry zimekuwa ni ferry za kukwama kila wakati.
Accidents have been happening here with reckless abandon, and many say that the Mtongwe tragedy of the 90s has not really been taken into account. The lessons that the tragedy brought out have not really been picked up by the Kenya Ferry Services, and we've seen accidents happening here, mothers delivering in the ferry with no one really to care for them. And although it takes an average, it should take about 15 minutes or 10 minutes to cross from one end to the other, it has been taking much longer, half an hour or sometimes even an hour plus.
Kwa hivyo siwezi elewa ni management ya yule mkubwa aliyokuwa pale ama ni kitu gani kinasumbua. Lakini sasa sisi watu wadogo huwa tukiona kule kuna jamu tunabaki na kushangaa. Na kama ilikuwa ni management ya huyo mkubwa aliyokuwa anasumbua, kwa sababu unaweza ingia ferry ukamaliza masaa matatu, ferry yaenda paka Florida, baadaye ya kuzungusha kuleta paka huku, ile time ulikuwa uende kazini inabidi ukose.
There are about four vessels here that ferry people, and they have been all undergoing several mechanical problems. Two vessels were brought in a few years ago, but they appear to have even more problems than those, the age-old problems, than the age-old vessels that have been operating here. And the question that has been asked by many is why really there has not been found a permanent solution. Many have proposed a construction of a bridge that will connect the south coast and the north coast. We've seen the cabinet secretary for tourism, Najib Balala, proposing a bridge to be built between the north coast and the south coast to help end this problem. The Dongokundu bypass is also something that has been proposed and say that will help ease this kind of congestion, but many say this may not really be the permanent solution, or rather the exhaustive solution, and therefore they are proposing a bridge to be built to connect the two islands.
Sasa unakuta hizi mpya kidogo hazijachukua muda mrefu, lakini hizi za zamani zimechukua muda mrefu kidogo. Sasa tunashindwa ni usimamizi ama engine za spare parts zao za ferry ndio zina shida, kati zile mpya hizi ndizo ziko sawa ama zile za zamani ndio engine zao ziko sawa.
And this latest discussion cannot really end without mentioning the Waitiki land factor. With the opening of the Waitiki land, it is expected that many more people will now decide to reside in Likoni. And this will mean that the population that crosses the ferry, uses the ferry services, will have to increase. And it is a factor that has to be factored in properly to ensure that things fall in place smoothly and caters for this huge number that is expected to be using the services here.
hapa ni kuongezwa feri mpya ambazo zinawakilisha kimaana.
Whether the sacking of top managers of the Kenya Ferry Services will help heal things here at the Kenya Ferry Services is a question that many will want really to ask and find and fix their eyes to know how things will end. And we will be keeping our eyes on the troubled parastatal to be able to give you details as they develop from the sacking to how things will be fixed in the end. My name is Francis Ontomwa for KTN News.